Welcome to the MicroTune tutorial about VCO calibration. If you have a VCO like the Sleeve Audio VCO or a Döpfer VCO, they're usually not perfectly in tune over a wide range of octaves. In fact, I deliberately decalibrated this VCO so I can show this in detail. I would like to demonstrate this. I connect the CV output of MicroTune to the CV input of this VCO. And I turn it up, and if I now play an A over some range of octaves, you can immediately hear that this is not a pure perfect octave. In fact, we can measure this by using a spare output of the VCO, or we double the existing output like so, and using the gate input of MicroTune to measure the frequency. We can measure the frequency in hertz, or we can measure the frequency as note with an offset in cents. If we now adjust the pitch of the VCO to A and we use the fine adjust to adjust it to zero, and now I play A over a range of octaves, you can see one octave up it's already minus 9.5 cents, minus 24, one octave higher, and minus 46, one octave higher. Luckily, MicroTune has a VCO calibration built in, and we do that by selecting Tools, VCO calibration. We select the channel, which is 1 in this case, and we select manual VCO calibration. Now MicroTune sends out 0 volts and measures the frequency of the VCO at this point. It's 16.5 Hz, and we select 1 volt. And it will measure the frequency here, and it tells you the offset is minus 0.08 Hz. So we can adjust this voltage a little bit and set it to zero. We go to the next octave and adjust it here again to read zero. I'm repeating this for all the octaves that are relevant to me. You can do that for all 10 octaves, but I'm only doing it for 5 or so, I think. This VCO calibration can be saved and recalled. It doesn't have to be the same channel, it can be any channel. So you could save it as Leaf Audio VCO 1 and load it whenever you use this VCO. Let me demonstrate how it is now. I will go and play A's of various frequencies. Let's adjust the frequency to zero again. One octave up, and as you can hear, it's much better, but the one I didn't calibrate is of course off. But the ones I did calibrate are now perfectly in tune. The VCO calibration can also be combined with the automatic tuning, which is explained in another video. Thank you for watching, and make sure to watch the other tutorial videos as well.